And you saw it right there,
yes.
And you said it right before we went to ABC News that the president has won in Ohio. If everything holds up with those numbers, he would
right.
have 275 electoral votes. All he needs is 270. We'd love to get our thoughts now from
right.
our political analysts. You know, we made it to 10:20. I know we talked about how late we were going to find out.
Right.
Just give me your thoughts, gentlemen.
Well, it's a stunning blow to the Republicans. If you can't beat an incumbent, well, it's always hard to beat an incumbent, no question about that. But if you can't beat this incumbent with this kind of a sorry record over the last 4 years, one of the things that the Republicans know for sure is Obamacare is a reality. There's no turning it back, so it's just going to march on. And, of course, now the Republicans have got to wonder what kind of candidate could have lost to this guy. Where is our fault in all this? And I suspect one of the things they'll say to themselves is, we served up a milquetoast moderate, and is that the best kind of candidate to run against an incumbent sitting president?
Well, I think, Matt, a couple of things are in play. This is the first campaign we have seen where the numbers really were economically bad, the unemployment was high, but yet the country gave President Obama another term. And I think that's what that's saying is, we believe we're headed in the right direction. I personally hope we're headed in the right direction for our country's sake. And they're going to give him an opportunity to develop policies over the next 4 years. And again, I hope and trust that those members in Congress, the president, can work together to help move our country forward.
What's interesting is a sizable majority don't think we're headed in the right direction. Even Democrats, a number of them will say, not headed in a good direction. And we've heard nothing from this president that would suggest we're heading in a slightly different direction to cure what ails us.
Well, when you look at the number of jobs that's created over the last 44 months with positive job creation versus where we were before he took office, I think people gave him the benefit of the doubt of it being really a tough time. So now I think the true parts come out in everyone. What can we do to move things forward? And I think the pressure will be on the president, but the pressure will also be on Congress as well, Democrats and Republicans, to work together to make this happen.
Mm-hmm.
Obviously, the economy has been slow. It's been struggling. Unemployment is still high. But through all that, over the last 4 years, the president's likability ratings have remained very high. Do you think that had a lot to do with this outcome tonight?
I don't think it's any question about it. Even the Republicans have said, you know, he's an easy guy to like. And everything around him indicates that. You may disagree with his policies, but most people think he's a decent, nice, likable kind of guy. And I just believe that does help you in a lot of instances.
A lot of the networks tonight were talking in terms of the empathy factor with Mitt Romney. Simply, he didn't empathize with the plight of the people, and that was problematic for him. I don't know if that's true or not, but that's what a lot of people seem to be talking about.
Well, at the end of the day, if people do not bond with you, if they don't have an attraction to you, then it's harder to overcome. And I think Mitt Romney demonstrated that over the course of the campaign. A little aloof, a little standoffish a little bit, and I think that made it a little bit harder.
And did he really let people know where he wanted to go with this nation? I think you could make that critique of the president, but did the challenger really let people know this is exactly where I want to head and this is exactly what I'd like to do in the next 4 years?
Thank you so much. We're going to check